Can money make you happy? Happiness is the feeling that everyone is chasing. Everyone wants to be happy. But can money bring you this incredible feeling? If we think outside the box, we'll see that money is just a piece of paper that basically controls our lives. It's a thin paper that you can buy almost everything with. But could you buy happiness with money? Well, theoretically speaking, you cannot go into a store and straight up buy a bag of happiness, no matter how much money you'd have, but you could go into a store and buy a Lamborghini, which will make you happy, right? Or you could go into a store and buy the latest phone that everyone brags so much about and that will make you happy and somehow at the same time superior to the others who do not own it. But these are just material things. In time, you'll get bored of it and you'll want more and more. In one interview, Dan Bilzerian, whose net worth is about $150 million, said, and quote, "You can buy happiness, but you can buy pleasure though, and I'll give you an example. When I was 16, my dream car was a Mustang Cobra, alright? So if I got a Mustang Cobra, I would have been at a 10, but a Ferrari would also bring me to a 10, but you can't go higher than a 10, okay? So let's say that I got a Ferrari when I was 16 and now we flash forward to when I graduate college and my dad gives me a BMW M5. If I had a Ferrari now, I'm going to be probably like a 7 because I'm stepping down in a car. But if I had a Mustang Cobra and now I'm going to an M5, I will be back at a 10. Well, it's the same car. You're the same person. You're in the same spot in life. The only difference is your perspective because your previous experience. So basically he's saying that money can't buy you happiness, but you can buy pleasure and only to a certain point, because if you buy something that gives you pleasure, the next time you'll have to buy something even better to give you the same amount of pleasure that you got from previous item. And you'll reach a point where you'll only be satisfied from very exclusive things or not at all. But wait, you might now be thinking that, well, if someone will come to me and give me a Ferrari, I'll be very happy, or if I won the lottery now, I'll be very happy. Yes, that's true, but not for so long. There's so many examples out there where normal people won lottery and not long after, they hated their lives. William Post won $16 million from buying lottery tickets with his last $40 that he pawned some stuff for it. Well, one of the tickets brought him the big win. Now every one of us would think that his life would be so much great from that point on. But that's not the case. William's life took a turn to worse. Everybody dreams of winning money, but nobody realizes the nightmares that come out of woodwork or the problems, William said. After winning the big pot, he spent almost $400,000 on the first 2 weeks, and after a year, he was $500,000 in debt. His girlfriend sued him, claiming that he promised if he wins he's gonna share the prize in two. She won in court and he could not pay because his lottery winnings were frozen. Even worse, his brother hired a hitman to kill him. He eventually ended up with no money. So many stories like this one, where poor people win a lot of money in one go and they sooner or later go broke. But why? Could you handle so much money from all of a sudden? Majority of these people were normal people with a 9-to-5 job like us, or even poor people that could not afford a meal and they were testing their luck playing lottery. Winning so much all of a sudden, it's a curse. They were not financially educated, they were not used to that much money and they were spending constantly, thinking the money will last for the rest of their lives. But in the end, they found out that's not the case. But there's one more example that I would like to talk about, and that's Jack's story. Jack Whittaker won $314 million in Christmas morning of 2002. He chose to check out all the money and after paying taxes, he was left with around $90 million. Jack was already wealthy when he won the big prize. He rose himself from poverty to a CEO of a West Virginia contracting company with a net worth of almost $17 million. Even though he did a lot of good with his donating to charity and buying the woman who sold him the lucky ticket a house, a car and giving her a pile of cash, the curse still reached to him. People started suing his company to get some money out of his pockets. His granddaughter boyfriend was found dead from an overdose and soon after, his granddaughter was also found dead. 7 years after winning the big pot, his daughter died also and his wife filed for divorce. He started drinking a lot and get caught into fights. Since I won the lottery, I think there's no control for greed. I think if you have something, there's always someone else who wants it. I wish I'd turned that ticket up, Jack Whittaker said. So it seems that even if you have the financial education needed for controlling that much money, you could also lose the big wins from the lottery. In my opinion, Jack should have cashed out annually and not all at once, so he could get paid gradually, so he could manage way better the money he won. Well, that's how every one of us would say, but let's face it, in the moment you realize you are rich from all of a sudden, your mind can't think clearly and you'll definitely want to cash out all the money at once to enjoy it, rather than getting paid small amounts yearly or monthly. Now, coming back to the initial question, could money buy you happiness? Well, no. No, it can't. It can only buy pleasure only for a certain amount of time, but it could definitely improve your life.